When the pandemic started, we had a strategy which we denominated people first. So for us, we are very much aware that, you know, anything that we do in business, despite the systems, despite the aeroplanes and all the trucks that we do move, are depending on people that are working in our organization. So the first thing we did was to make sure that our people are safe. The second thing we did was to make sure that their jobs are safe. And the third thing we did was to make sure that they can safely support our customers, because the purpose of business is called connecting people and improving lives. In terms of change of strategy, we had to accelerate the implementation of all of our tools across the Middle East and Africa region, but also across the globe. So, and that is the reason why, you know, platforms such as Saludo, which is our digital freight platform, was deployed in all the countries during the pandemic. So nobody could travel, but we could do it, you know, from far away. The second thing we did is that we deployed our MyDHLi tool and our IT tool, IRR we call it. We deployed it in all of our countries. So now in all of our countries, we're using the most modern digital tools to be able to work. And lastly, we made sure that everybody was equipped enough to be able to work from home with, you know, hardwares and systems that allow them to work remotely. And lastly, obviously, we use all the new technologies to daily engage with all of our employees to know that everybody is safe and good. We actually talk about people living in Dubai being resolved and showing willingness and determination to make sure that, you know, everything that we have been operating out of Dubai is still something that is working. So for us, you know, we have never ceased operating in Dubai. So it is not about being back on track, but rather more to be able to convince our customers, because some markets were closed, some others were opened, to make sure that our customers see the same opportunities as our people that are working and operating in different countries see, so that people can explore new market opportunities. So what we have seen, for example, is that we have had a high increase in trading between Dubai and Africa. You know, it has grown by over 20%. And we have been helping people who are trading from Dubai to reach out to markets such as those in North Africa, in East Africa, but also now particularly in South Africa, which was not really a focus trade then for businesses operating out of Dubai. Last year, we launched our Global Humanitarian Competence Center in Dubai, which was before we knew there would be any pandemic happening. And indeed, you know, with a great collaboration together with Emirates Airlines, together with the international humanitarian cities and some international organizations, we were able to organize Ubuntu, which was a charter solution, you know, bringing goods from China, hubbing through Dubai and distributing to many different countries. So we moved over 200 million masks and protective equipment to people across the globe.